Martina. I'm a law student and I'm coming from Padova.
Hi everyone, I'm Cosimo and I'm coming from Padova too.
I'm Miriam and I'm studying Padova too.
Hello, I'm Sofia. I am from Pisa and I'm studying Padova.
Hi, I'm Francesco. I'm studying in Padova and I'm from Novara.
Okay, I think we can start.
Yes.
So starting with the presentation, we're going to talk first of all about the problem. And we are going to say that in Greece, refugees are facing employment, financial and integration issues. And looking at the global market, as also Ms. Spadafora also said before, the fast fashion trend exploits workers, in some cases even child labor, by having both a negative social and environmental impact. Naomi bases its business on fair and ethical employment, ecological sustainability, and empowerment of disadvantaged people. Now, going on to the business model, we're going to see that, first of all, the key partners would be raw material suppliers, universities, design schools, bigger brands, alternative trading organizations, brand ambassadors, influencers, shippers, and distributors. Then moving on to the key activities, we have language and sewing courses, fundraising campaigns and events, website and social media management, the e-commerce business, and guided visits. Moving on to key resources, we have physical resources, for example, a textile laboratory, human resources, mainly volunteers, and finally, financial resources, which are mainly proceeds from sale. Going to maybe the most important part, which is the value proposition, we have to say that Naomi gives a value to refugees, clients, and to society. And in specific, it provides clients with emotional, functional, and economic value. Going on to customer relations, Naomi is going to send a letter from the refugee who made the item of clothing directly to the client. Then they're going to use newsletters, customer service assistance, reviews, feedback, and service. Moving on to the channels, so we'll have both online and offline acquisition channels. Then regarding the cost structure, we'll have both fixed costs and variable costs. As regards fixed costs, for example, we have infrastructures and staff salaries. And for variable costs, for example, raw materials and water, electricity and gas bills. Going to the revenue streams, so we'll have mainly earning revenue, the charity founding, crowdfunding campaigns and institutions founding. Now to explain the next point, I'm going to use the next slide, which is market segmentation. And we're going to say that the targeted clients for Naomi are people from 20 to 65 years old, of all genders, who are economically independent, mainly coming from all over Europe, in specific Northern Europe. And in general, they are people who are sensitive to ecology, social issues, who are sensitive to themes of this kind and who are interested in eco-friendly, fashionable and high-quality clothing and accessories.
Now let's move on to the market analysis. And regarding the market potential, there are four market needs, and we can see it in this slide. And concerning the price, there is a significant demand for sustainable clothes on a budget. Another customer need is sustainable clothes in blue size. And in terms of style, both women are shifting towards casual and comfortable apparel. And lastly, ecological fabrics are getting more and more popular in the home textile market. Now let's move on to the competitive analysis. In the European market, the competition will most likely come from other NGOs and ethical and sustainable fashion companies. But there is no clear market positioning of Naomi in the market. But as the company combines different requirements that none of the other enterprises have, such as full size options or the home textile line, Naomi has the possibility to become a leader in this commerce. All the products are made by sustainable and eco-friendly materials and are divided into clothes, such as full size options, accessories, such as keyrings and bracelets, and home textile with kitchen garments and table linens. For the competitive age, there are five factors that distinguish Naomi from the other companies. The First one is that every product is unmade by refugees and it's one of a kind. Second, there is a meticulous attention to the quality and source of materials. Third, extra hours of language and singing lessons for refugees are donated by any purchase. The first is that there are two size options in the clothing line. And lastly, sustainable kitchen garments with a social impact are only sold by Naomi.
For the marketing strategy, which is the unique selling proposition behind Be One of a Kind, because people who buy Naomi's products help refugees and in exchange, they get unique fashionable items. On such a platform, USP will appear in the hashtag format Be One of a Kind. We apply different strategies to each step of the market funnel. In the first awareness stage, Naomi will make the public aware of the existence of their products with both online channels, such as websites, social platform, and offline channels by participating in events. Next, in the consideration stage, Naomi has to make visitors take into consideration buying the products by using blog articles, YouTube videos, and newsletter marketing. Next, potential clients will be encouraged to make the purchase by storytelling, reviews, and sales. Finally, to build customer loyalty, Naomi will provide customer support, a sense of community built around the hashtag Be One of a Kind, and positive reinforcement of the impact of the purchase by packaging a car report in Naomi's and a signed letter by a refugee. The strategies have been chosen for their viability, considering Naomi's current situation. As the company grows, each of them can be scaled up by investing in advertising and by increasing their resources.
Now, moving on to the growth strategy, from day one to month six, Naomi will fill vacancies, start negotiations with suppliers, shippers, distributors, and also possible partners, and also start to launch the new website. Moving to month six, to year two, they will start an aggressive marketing campaign in order to increase sales. In the medium run, they would increase training hours for refugees, also start to open the applications for interns and implement online advertising. While finally, in the long run, they will start to produce new lines, look for further new partners, and also develop an application for online sales. Talking about the selecting strategic partners, there are three kind of partners, starting from the supply chain partners like organic cotton producer and a rope supplier to produce bracelets and keyrings, while on academic partners, we talk about universities and school of communication and design that could be selected. And finally, on delivery partners, after a cost analysis, we would suggest Elta Hellenic Post as it is the cheapest one to send parcels throughout the whole Europe.
Okay, as you can see, we choose a chromatic palette with neutral colors, which reflect the values of Naomi, such as nature and hope. I can show the website. The menu is placed at the top of the page to facilitate navigation, and the shop entry gives the possibility to choose between accessory, clothes, and home textiles. In the shop page, a visitor can sort products by collection, price, size, categories, and there are tagged as a new arrival and bestseller. Users who embrace Naomi's mission can click on Get Involved, and there are several solutions for business, volunteers, and donors. We also wanted to integrate in the website several editorial and social strategies. The website makes the possibility to makes possible an implementation of the social media integration, and by filling this form, in the website footer, visitors may subscribe to Naomi's newsletter and be updated on the last development of the company. Opening the website, the same form is in a pop-up window. The journal is for us an important part of the website because it helps visitors to be involved in the Naomi's mission with real-life stories and insight about slow fashion. In order to create a web community, we also created the hashtag Be One of a Kind and a video commercial that I can show you concluded my statement.
Would you rescue me? Would you get my back? Would you take my car when I start to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me?
Would you rescue me when I'm by myself? When I need your love, if I need your help, would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? Would you get my back? Would you take my call when I start to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me?
Thank you.
Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, thank you very much, Dream Team. I'm perfectly on time. I'm surprised. Good for you. So now let's start the question and answer round. We are always going to follow the same order. Okay, so the first one who is able to make questions is Mr. Alessandro Signorini. Mr. Signorini, if you want to make any question to the team.
Yeah, I mean, what I will do with all the questions, I will ask something about marketing, that is my area. And I'm particularly concerned about the target market, because it's 20 to 65. Don't you think that a 20-year-old person would be very different than a 65-year-old person? And also, getting on your, let's say, business plan, I noticed that you target Northern European markets in general. But don't you think that given the limited resources that Naomi has, you should limit in one national market, max two national markets? So, and also, if you look at the advertising that you posted, the video, I would say that it's very young in terms of audience, the website as well, while again, you say that your market is 20 to 65 years old, and I don't see any specific strategy within, let's say, the 50 and the 65 years old. So my main concern and my question would be, why don't you limit the primary market and you make a stronger choice?
If I can answer to that, we were thinking about considering a higher range of people, because young people are very interested in those topics, for example, environment, sustainability, and they're the ones who are more who actually are more interested in those type of, who are looking for those type of things when talking about clothing. And but on the other hand, their problem is that they don't have enough money, because of course they are mainly students, so they don't have the economic availability to buy those type of clothes. But on the other hand, comparing the two factors, the fact if they have to make a decision basing well, what I want to say is that if they have, for example, a small amount of money, if they have 20 euros and they have to decide on what to spend those money, it's more likely that they will spend it in buying a Naomi t-shirt, because it's something they really give value to it. And that's why we chose to target like young people. On the other hand, the people who are, for example, 65 years old have a greater economic availability, and that's why they're more prone to buy those type of clothes.
Yeah. Mr. Sarcinelli?
Yes. Okay, if I can add something. To target the older older people, we decided to extend the Naomi's offer, because we added products such as earrings, bracelets that can be used for gifts, such as from grandmas to grandnephews, granddaughters, and also the home textile. Textile category, because there are products that can be used by ages older than teenagers, and can also be used for gifts, because people are very interested in decorating their home, and so we can also make cross-selling between home textiles for the kitchen and home textiles for the table linens.
No, I agree, but remember that, you know, if you choose, no company, in particular a very small company, would have such a broad market. And in particular, if you have such a broad market, you should provide a consistent promotional strategy. So I agree, and I don't see any problem in what you say, but, you know, first of all, focus your resources, and secondly, you know, again, provide a promotional strategy, because, you know, even your video, everything that you do, is not targeted to the older audience. So, you know, pay attention to that. Thank you so much anyway for your answers.
Okay, thank you very much. Mr. Sarcinelli, do you have any question to the team?
Yes, on my side, I was just wondering on the product offer. So I think maybe it's quite similar to the client, so audience you're targeting. Maybe isn't it too wide, the product offer you want to produce and offer to the market? Also in terms of resources you have internal in the company, actually the expertise you are developing maybe couldn't be enough to satisfy all the product offer you want to sell in the market.
Okay. Now, Mr. Gensch, do you want to question to make any question to the team?
Yes, Juan. what you've done, folks, is that you, in my opinion, established a marketing plan rather than a business plan. I like it very much. It's a very good one. But I'm missing one or the other word to the financial threats that Naomi has to encounter. As you know, there is the funding of the churches that helps Naomi go its way, but these fundings, this money, will diminish in the next years. And I wished you had said something how Naomi could close this gap until it comes to doing its marketing job, websites and things like these.
Okay.
Yes, this one, the fact of unconstant financial income, is like stated in the, we treated it in the risk analysis. We consider the fact that funds from church are not like perpetual, so they will diminish, and we consider it as a risk. And yes, for this reason also we suggested Naomi to like schedule a correct allocation of resources, because they are not they will be uneven through the growth stages, like, and this is a great risk, because 1 year you know what you get, but next year you don't know, for a lot of reasons. For you will know if you will get any more financial income. This is, for example, in the case of a crisis like COVID-19 now, probably the churches or previous founders are giving this money to people who need help, for because they are in financial risk because of COVID-19, rather than to Naomi. And yes, we consider this as a risk, and for this reason we would suggest to become more self-sustainable by trying to sell the most clothes we can.
Yes, and in addition to that, we thought about asking to some institutions funding, for example, to the government and to the EU. For example, we saw that until I think next year, there's a 7-year funding program of the European Union, which aim is to help organizations and in general refugees. So we were thinking maybe they're gonna renew it next year. And so when they're going to renew it, and Naomi can ask it to apply to it, and so maybe it can get also those types of funding. Together with that, we also thought about all the crowdfunding campaigns, and for example, the crowdfunding on the platform GoFundMe that now has become really popular, especially in this COVID-19 period, and also with the Instagram and Facebook funding campaigns. And so together with that, we're gonna increment the resources that for Naomi. We actually didn't consider very much the churches, because of course it's a really unstable type of income.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Olga and Mr. Gensch.
And answering to Mr. Sarcinelli, yes, we considered that the expanding the offer can pose difficulties for the workers. So we made research and we saw that building bracelets from scraps are actually very, very easy. There are tutorials on the internet. So it's something that everyone could make at home, but obviously the added value is that buying these products from Naomi has the Naomi's name and also social and environmental impact. And for the economic point of view of the added products, we suggest using scraps from material that Naomi already uses, for example, using scraps from Idomeni blankets for the keyrings and so on.
Okay. Now I would like to give the floor to the juror, Ricciardi Celsi. do you have any question or comment to the students, Lorenzo?
Yeah, just a few quick remarks. I agree with the observations made by the other members of the jury, especially the fact that seems much more of a marketing plan rather than a business plan. Talking about a business plan, I would have expected at least a glimpse of how developing these products, you are able to yield relevant benefits for the users, those who buy, and revenues that ultimately proved to be higher than the production costs. Anyway, also the promotional strategy should have been wider, but I believe that by participating to initiatives such as this, you learn on the field how to what are the weaknesses and strengths of your approach. So the presentation was good and clear. Maybe if it had been made a little bit slower, it could have helped because you went a bit faster on some interesting points. Anyway, one brief question. When you talk about a business strategy and competitive advantage, it is not so clear to me what is the other products on the market, which are the other products on the market you are going to prove that your products are advantages upon. In other words, which are the products you are referencing towards? What is the product? I would have expected some examples of other products with respect to which yours are better, with some sort of a chart or benchmark in some ways that better show this.
As we are running out of time, I think we are going directly to go to the feedback of the remaining jurors. Okay, and then we will begin with them in the next team. Helge, you are next. Which feedback do you want to provide the green team?
Well, first of all, thank you guys for the tremendous work you put into the project and the presentation. Really, really happy to see your results. My feedback would be to echo what Alessandro said in the beginning. For me, not being a marketing specialist, more like a communicator or fundraising specialist, that the segmentation was too broad for me. Like 25 to 65 was a too big group for me, as well as you kind of did the second step before the first. You said that Naomi should reach out to, you know, all over Europe or Northern Europe without saying like what are the first steps they first have to do in Greece or other markets maybe. Yeah, this would be my feedback. My question would be the fundraising perspective you mentioned. You said it would be a nice way to reach out to people. I got this from your business plan as well. But how would you actually do it? What would be the strategy behind it?
Okay, if I can first answer to Mr. Ricciardi Celsi. Yes, maybe we are sorry we were so fast, but we had very limited time. So we also had to cut a lot of our business plan in the presentation. So maybe that's the reason why it seems like more of a marketing plan than a business plan, because a lot of our SWOT analysis, risk analysis, competitive analysis got cut for that reason. And also we made in fact examples of competition products such as People Tree or Gather and See, but we couldn't tell about them on during our presentation. And yes, so other products that we considered for the competition were products from social business that have both a business, both an environmental impact and a social impact, such as Carcel, that sells products made from people who are in jail. And we say that our competitive edge is that we offer not only a social and environmental impact, but also lower prices and size options more vaster than them, and also other categories of products such as accessories and home textiles. And okay. Also for the fundraising, we made some examples on our business plans, such as yes, from social media, but also during offline events, in for example, organizing charity runs or organizing
other promotional events, for example, when doing a conference. For example, we thought about doing a round of conferences around Europe. And when after presenting the business of Naomi, organizing like a stand where people can come and buy, for example, t-shirts and all kinds of products of Naomi. So in that sense, we were thinking about both kind of ways of raising money, both online with, of course, the crowdfunding platforms and social media, and offline during conferences and other promotional events. Also, for example, in Italy, we have a very popular running in December, which is for Telethon, and where people pay, for example, from a minimum amount of money of €5, and then they can donate as much as they want, and they participate in this run, and all the all the money which are paid from the participants goes to the research. In this case, doing a similar thing to Naomi would be organizing a run, for example, in Thessaloniki. And in that kind of event, people, all the money given from people will be donated to Naomi.
Okay, thank you very much, Martina and Sofia. Now I would like to please ask Maria Giulia and Giorgia, who are the last jurors, the ones who just did the website, to make a very, very brief feedback that will have to remain unanswered if it's a question. But we are running out of time and the next team has to proceed with their presentation. So I don't know if you want to add or to comment anything on their website, Maria Giulia.
I want to say that your website is very simple and basic. The template is user-friendly, but it's a bit too essential and doesn't reflect very well the entire activity of Naomi. This is, and my question is the following, as also in the choice of the main picture of the homepage or in the pictures used in the video, which is very nice, but doesn't have anything about refugees, about this human aspect of Naomi, as others focused on this, on the refugee stories more than you. And I think that the best is to mix the things. Maybe it's a choice you wanted to do, not putting so many pictures of refugees, of Naomi, of the stories from refugees camp, or it's just, I don't know, probably you just wanted to focus on the marketing and the e-shop.
Okay, I can answer. Okay.
Francesco, do you mind? We also go for Georgia's feedback and questions, so you can reply all together and make it a bit shorter. Georgia, do you want to make any feedback, provide any feedback to the participants, to make any questions from them?
I would like to add a small feedback for them to think about, because it has to do with the words they use during the presentation, and then actually my question, I would put it more or less similar with the one of Maria, because it has to do with visual language that is somehow lacking part of the message that we want to give with Naomi. So they can answer on the question of Maria. But what I would like to say, Martina used at some point when she was talking for the value to clients, she said that The emotional value is the social and environmental impact. For my opinion, it's not emotional. The way we value the social and environmental impact should not have to do with emotion anymore in 2020. It is not because we are kind people. It is because it has to do with being clever. So for me, in your presentation, this was a little bit, the use of this word was a little bit misleading. And then Mr. Cosimo Masotti,
yes,
said something about aggressive marketing campaign.
Yes.
For me, again, an issue, because when we are talking about fair trade and about changing somehow the way this world is moving, we should not be aggressive anymore. Aggressive marketing is something that has caused a lot of the issues we want to solve, in my opinion. So, okay, this is more a part of my, let's say, artistic emotional sensitivity with words. And then from the part of the visual communication, you could just answer to the question of Maria, and I'm totally covered.
Okay, so Francesco, I give you less than 1 minute to reply because we have to move for the next. So please brief.
Yeah, in the website, I didn't show you all the website. There are some parts where there is more about the story behind Naomi and the story of refugees and what Naomi is about. but we wanted not to be the main part of the website, because we think that a person who wants to buy a cloth from Naomi want to buy a cloth because it's beautiful, because it's maybe ecological, and that's the first thing. Then he knows also the story of Naomi and the what behind every t-shirts, every clothes, and that is a plus. But if the first thing that a user views of Naomi in the website is that it helps refugees and yes, the story of Naomi. Maybe the impression is that buying clothes, he's not buying it because it's a beautiful cloth, but because he's doing something like charity. Yeah, in the website there are some part where the story of Naomi is very, as I can say, there is the story, and in the journal there are stories of refugees. There are some insights about I don't know why slow fashion, why helps refugees, why the journal for that is a very important part of the website, because helps visitors to know more about Naomi and more about why Naomi is producing.
Maybe you just have to put some connections in the home page. So the first thing you see, and the main page you see, you watch, you visit to the journal, which is one part of the website, which is very much divided from the rest of the website. This is why I had this comment. But okay. I think the time is finished.
And Guillermo, yes. if I can,
I'm afraid. Sorry, Cosimo. I have to remain strict.
You can write me. You can write
yes,
me.
Yes, you will have the chance to.
I just wanted to answer the question about the aggressive marketing campaign.
Yes, of course.
And me, okay,
20 seconds. Cosimo, go fast.
No problem. Okay.
I need more of the feedback for you to
yes.
We work. Can write it down, no?
Yeah.
Okay,
so thank you very much, guys. You did a great job. Thank you for your presentation. It's been amazing. And well done, really well done.